But I want to share something with you this morning. And does everyone know the last poets?
Yes.
The last poets.
Some preparation. I have no hot water, no TV, no AC. Okay, so you're ready for the revolution.
Or a small room.
Or a small room. One thing the Japanese showed me is that boy, you get a whole lot of the parts, including the dick.
Are we still holding hands?
You don't have to. But just make sure that you continue to touch. But for the mirror is another tribute to our ancestors. And every opportunity that we have to pay tribute to the ancestors, we should.
Yes.
So this is for the millions. For the millions of Africans chained to slave ships. For the millions of scars on backs and faces by the bullwhip. For the millions who jumped overboard for the mud that poured on the shores of North America, South America, Central America, Europeans. He's living in the ocean as a grave on Africa and refused to be a slave. For the millions who cut the cane, picked the cotton, whose names have been forgotten, whose flesh has rotted with the trees that they hung us from. Cut out our tongues, cut off our hands if we played the drums. For the millions who were shot, hunt, beat to death, tarred and feathered, boiled in oil, whiplash, broke a sack and thrown in the river, and I want us to be close enough to be open. So we were castrated, miseducated, segregated, integrated, legislated by the constipated. For the millions who've been lied to, denied to, vampire-eyed to, misguided to, and not abided to, so we decided to get together and change the weather. Not just now, but forever. We decided to love each other. Stop the madness and be real sisters and brothers. We decided to stop. Take a look at the beauty of ourselves. And this colored skin, this thick hair, and these full lips, and this Africa all inside our souls, still breathing the breath of God in our minds. Greatness is where we're coming from. For the millions who marched, sang, prayed, sat in, laid in, lived in, jailed in, boycotted and picketed, spit at, cursed at, yelled at, like blacks not wearing that, like we should be satisfied to ride in the back. For the Fannie Lou Hamers, the Rosa Parks, and the Eula Mae Johnsons, and Harriet, and Silas Sepour, and Gwendolyn Brooks, and the Martins, and the Arthurs, the Reapers, Panthers, James, Langston, Richard, Paul, Malik, Marcus, and Matt. CQ, and PPPQ. For the millions who know, and those who always know, that no matter what, plus the earth shall rise again. No matter how many bullets and prisons, diseases and deaths, no one can take our breath away. We are here instead. No matter how much liquor and crack, nothing can kill the fact that we were divine creation, started civilization, built the pyramids and the Sphinx, taught the world how to play and think, not to mention inventions we never got close to. All the babies that we raised, even when our own work is born. For the millions with fire in their souls that burn so bright, the strength of our will is dominant as the night. And the rhythm when we walk, and the rhythm when we talk, even when we don't have shit to say.
Come on.
You are the sounds that put color in your lip. The mirror are ready to turn this thing around. It's time to turn to our spiritual home.
prevalent
than it is today. They say you don't come from nowhere, but we prove them wrong. They tell us to go back to Africa. Well, we go. We get the hell out of there. First place. And we're going to continue to do what we've been doing, which is to rebuild our legacy as African people. And not be ashamed of this nappy hair and these full lips and that big buttocks that everybody wants, but now they shooting shit up into their lips.
Everything.
Everybody wants their ass. And it don't fit. So we are a proud people, and it does me so much good from the time I came to Africa to now to see how many of my sisters, their hair was blowing in the wind, nappy as if it was, but lovely.
Yes.
All right. I don't think I'm saying it
now. Yeah.
So I want us to take a moment, and I want you to close your eyes. And I want you to hold somebody's hand. But y'all are the family, y'all are the family. We're the people. I may not have birthed you. We may not have the same mama, same dad. But we are the family. So I just want you to close your eyes, listen to the sounds and waves, and think about that person or persons that you want to say something to, that you put off saying something to, because you're mad, you're pissed off. And then all of a sudden the person dies. And you be the first one at the funeral. You jump in the box.
Oh God, don't leave me! Mama! Damn me, please, God, don't leave me!
He was the worst child in here. Okay. He has a friend that ain't my friend no more because of what she did to me. She ain't my friend. We held with her. And then she died. And then you sit around talking about, oh, that was a great friend of mine. And we did this, we did that, but you let her get out of here without expressing to her how much I love you. So my niece is coming to see us New Year's Eve, 2000. We happen to be in America. And she wrote this little piece. And when I saw it, she said, you know, Mama, I was thinking about us, thinking about the family, and I just didn't think it was time. I wrote things down that I needed to say. And the title of the piece is called If I Knew. If I knew this would be the last time that I'd see you fall asleep, I would tuck you in more tightly and pray more of your soul. If I knew it would be the last time that I would see you walk out the door, I would give you a hug and a kiss and call you back for one more. If I knew it would be the last time I'd hear your voice lifted up in praise, well, I would dignotate each action and word so I could play it back then. If I knew it would be the last time I could spare a minute or two to stop and say I love you instead of assuming you with no idea. If I knew it would be the last time I would be there to share with you, well, I'm sure you'll have so many more so I can just let this one. Well, surely there's always tomorrow to make up for an overcome. And we always make everything. There will always be another day to say our I love you. And certainly there's another chance to say, anything I can do. But just in case I might be wrong, and today is all get, I'd like to say how much I love you, and I hope will never forget. Tomorrow is not promised to anyone, young or old alike. And today may be the very last chance that you get to hold your love. So if you're waiting for tomorrow, why not do it today? For if tomorrow never comes, you'll surely regret today that you didn't take that extra time for a smile, for a hug, or for a kiss. And you were too busy to grant someone what turned out to be your one last wish. So hold your loved ones close today and whisper in their ear. Tell them how much you love them and that you're always holding you. Take time today. If tomorrow never comes, you'll have no regret. That was written by Bobby Bowles with love on 1st January 2000.